Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel.
Today's video is gonna be how to kind of set yourself right for the new year and start 2019 like a boss.
Really more than anything, we just wanna like do this video to get you set up to be able to tackle all of the goals that you have this year and really just kind of grow up and be an adult.
So if you're new to our channel and just stumbling across this, welcome to our channel. Hunter and I do daily vlogging, travel vlogs, fashion, beauty, home, all sorts of stuff. So feel free to stick around.
Today is the first video of a new concept and series that we created called My Life is in Shambles. And the whole concept behind that is we get a lot of questions around tips and tricks of how, like, how we bought our first house or how we like became an adult or things that we do, like tips and tricks of just in life in general and how to like declutter your life.
And we know we have so many different age groups here, so a lot of people in college, maybe graduating, married, starting their life. So we just want to help you guys with this series figure out how to adult better and do all the boring stuff that we hate to do but we have to.
Yeah.
So without further ado, today's video, we're going to start off the My Life is in Shambles series and show you guys how to be a boss in 2019.
Let's jump into the video. We are going to start off by talking about a few different topics and categories around like getting your life in place for 2019. First category is
setting goals. So I actually never used to be like a goal setting person specifically. I would think about them in my head, but I never like structured it and wrote it down on paper. So Hunter and I have kind of set a few goals for this year. One of mine being really to kind of be a healthier person all around. I know that's always a classic resolution, but I think for us, really we're focusing on like work-life balance this year and staying active and eating healthy and sleeping more and like working on our mental health.
Totally. Almost. Yeah. Definitely like an area we need improvement for sure.
Absolutely.
Yeah. When thinking about health, like a lot of us think about only working out or only diet or, you know, only mental health, but it's definitely a combination of all of the above. So when it comes to diet, we pay attention to our diet for the most part. Like we are cognizant about what we eat, what we don't eat, and we try to stay pretty healthy for the most part.
Yeah.
But working out is something we definitely need to improve on.
Totally. So we're trying to make small attainable goals that are realistic. For example, we're gonna try and start working out maybe like 2 to 3 times a week. So if we were to say 7 days a week, that might not be actually realistic. This is something we can actually reach. So make sure you keep that in mind when setting goals. So one thing I'm going to definitely do to motivate myself is download maybe like a new fitness app that can give me like a little bit more structure to my workouts.
Something to follow.
Yeah. And secondly, buying super cute active wear that always helps me get motivated to go to the gym. I think it helps a lot of people. So wanted to say thank you so much to Lululemon for collaborating with us on this portion of today's video. They are trying to motivate people to reach their 2019 goals of being healthy and active and promoting a healthy lifestyle by getting them excited about cute fitness wear.
And Lululemon's one of those places that every time I'm in there, I have to like talk myself out of buying things because I love everything in the store. So it's hard to pick, for sure.
I know. They have really good stuff. It's such good quality. So I wanted to show you guys a little outfit that I picked out from Lululemon. The first are my favorite leggings ever from Lululemon. They are worth every penny and they honestly last forever. I've had some of them from like 5 years ago and they last.
Are those the 4.5s or whatever they're called?
The 7.8s.
7.8s.
Yeah. These are the 7.8s pant. These ones are the movement tight, so they're really good for running and training. But for short people, I love where they hit on the ankle and they're just the perfect length. They're not a crop, but they're not a full legging. And this really pretty color is kind of like a purple mauve color. To go with that, I got a little burgundy sports bra. It has this really cute floral cutout right in the center, and I thought these were kind of the same color family and kind of give a winter slash spring vibe. And I can wear these separately or together, and they look really cute as a set.
What if you get cold?
If I get cold, I have this really cute white long sleeve. I think the white looks really cute against the purple colors, the contrast, and this is a great like basic workout top to just kind of throw over things, and if I get hot at the gym, I can just peel it off and wear my sports bra when I'm like in the middle of a workout. But for winter, it's nice to have the long sleeve for a little throw over.
It's a cute outfit.
I'll link all these items in the description box down below if you guys want to check them out on Lululemon's site, but I'm sure you're already aware they're the bomb.
Yeah, we definitely have goals that are more personal or independent or individual, but we also have goals as a couple, and so I think working out and like health is definitely something that we are both focused on, as well as like finances and things that we kind of pay attention to together.
Yeah.
It's definitely important to set your own goals, obviously, if you're, like, single, as well as being married, like, we each have our own goals independently, yeah. but we also have goals as a married couple.
For sure. So, if you're in college, I would recommend, like, doing your goal session with a buddy or a friend. You could do it with your mom,
yeah.
or if you have a boyfriend, like, it's just good to bounce ideas off of somebody, and they can help you be, like,
stay accountable.
Yeah, stay accountable.
Kind of hold you to, like, what you set your... A lot of people, like, I don't even know the goals I set for myself in 2018, so it's good to write them
yeah.
down and, like, hold someone or yourself accountable to those things.
So the categories that we've kind of broken our goals down into this year are health, career, recreational, which would be like traveling or passions that you want to pursue, personal, financial, and then for each other if
yeah.
you're like in a relationship or whatever. So our next tip for kind of setting your year off right after you set your goals is to kind of have what we like to call a little adulting session.
Yeah.
And adulting can be really hard, but this is a really good way to kind of give yourself a check-in and spend some time figuring out all of, like, organizing your life basically to make sure you are being efficient and responsible so that you can reach your goals.
So one way in our marriage that we kind of hold ourselves accountable in these adulting sessions is we rely heavily on Google spreadsheets.
Hunter and I like to sit down every once in a while, and for 2018 we'll sit
yeah.
down, maybe do it with a friend or, like I said earlier, a parent, and kind of just go through all of your bills. That's something that we, like when we were starting as young adults, we created a Google spreadsheet, like Hunter said, and put all of our bills on one page with all of the username, passwords to all the sites, because it can be really chaotic when you've got lots of stuff going on.
Yeah, just so we can both be responsible too, where it's like, I'm not the only one that knows about, you know, what this specific bill is and how to, like, log in and take care of it kind of thing.
Totally, and we both have access to it. So if it's like, if I'm in a meeting and he needs to pay something, he knows where to go, and vice versa, I know where to go if he's not available.
Totally.
So
yeah.
all in one place. We would highly recommend doing that. Helps to get organized. You
yep.
can access it from anywhere.
And then we also have, like, a completely separate spreadsheet that is around, like, we obviously, she said bills, but we have a completely spreadsheet that is more focused on our budgeting itself. So it includes those bills in there, but also, like, everything else that we pay for, how are we going to budget other areas of our lives, just to make sure we're on the same page and pursuing and kind of holding ourselves accountable towards the goals that we're wanting to pursue.
Totally, and I think you can do this no matter what age. I think we maybe started it a little bit later than we should have, but
yeah.
even if you're in college, or especially if you've just graduated, take a look at all of your responsibilities, all the bills that you have, how much you're making and how much is coming in, and kind of write out where everything is going out each month.
Yeah.
So what amount is going to each bill, your apartment rent, and then how much do you have left over at the end of each month, and how much do you want to save? And you can kind of organize it all. You don't have to follow it strictly, but
no.
just to have that set out in front of you will help you manage your money better.
Yeah, and, like, really, this goes hand in hand with even the goal piece of the conversation, which is around, like, if you have financial goals, like, you're able to hold yourself accountable on your financial goals based on your budgeting that you set for
Absolutely.
Yourself.
Absolutely. 100%. Will definitely help. You got to stay organized. So Google Sheets and just have yourself a little adulting session, go through your bills, your budget, and all that good stuff.
Yeah. So our next tip is to plan your calendar. Like, we rely very heavily on the calendars that we share, whether it's, like, Google Calendar, or we actually have calendars laying across the house where we have planning sessions around.
Yeah.
Like, if we have goals throughout the week or the month or the year that we want to get done, we sit down and have a planning session and actually put it on calendar.
Totally. So we like to sit down, and we took a look at all of 2019, talked about some of our goals that we had in terms of travel
yep.
and schedule and stuff like that. And we kind of just do, like, a really brief overview of, like, okay, maybe we want to go to Europe in the summertime, and we'll do, like, a snow trip to Colorado in the winter. And you kind of, like, lightly plot everything out so you have, like, a bird's eye view of the entire year and kind of what's coming.
With me traveling to San Francisco once a month, we put that on the calendar to know which weeks I'm going to be gone, so we can plan
mm-hmm.
everything else around it. And same with her LA trips. But just like she mentioned, some, like, vacations or trips that you want to go on, if you have a place that you desire to go, put on the calendar, like, in advance.
Yeah.
Like, there's been times where we wanted to go somewhere, and a year in advance, we just, like, book a flight and put it on the calendar. So we have to plan a trip when that time comes around. So it allows you to, like, create time for yourself as well as, like, to hold yourself accountable on things that you're supposed to do versus things you want to do.
And then if you have something on the calendar, let's say you're planning a trip with your girlfriends for, I don't know, Valentine's Day,
yeah.
or you have an anniversary trip, you can kind of work towards that financially too. And then you know, okay, I have 6 months to prepare this much money, and you can work that into your budget and start, everything just comes together and you just be like, boss.
Yep, so all the things we're talking about all go hand in hand with each other. The calendar planning, like your adulting, your goals, they all are really one and the same, but it's just a way to organize those things.
Totally.
And really the fourth topic and fourth item we want to discuss or kind of tell you about is be yourself.
Yeah.
Our biggest theme this year is to like be you. Like we want to be ourselves and be as raw and authentic as possible. And that's just like a message we want to pass on to all of you and really be a actual tip itself. It's just like, how are you gonna have your own goals if you aren't being yourself? Like, don't make goals based on other people's desire and wants. Like, be you and like go after things that you desire.
For sure. Keep that in mind when you're setting your goals. That's what Hunter and I thought about a lot. Just what do we want that's going to make us happy? What are our passions? What are things that are going to fulfill us? And it's not just all about what you can achieve, but what things can you do that will make your heart happy and just live your best you. So I hope you guys learned a tip or trick today on how you can start your 2019 like a boss. I hope you're excited about our new Life is in Shambles series. Leave us some recommendations for topics you want us to cover in the comments down below.
And also feel free to reach out to us anytime on Instagram. We read all of your DMs and answer every single one of them.
Mm-hmm.
So reach out anytime if you have any questions or suggestions for this video or for like a Spritz and Chips. Like, we love hearing your feedback and your thoughts and just suggestions in general.
Thank you guys so much for watching, and we hope you have an amazing 2019, and we'll see you in the next video.
Yeah, bye.
Bye.